Good afternoon, everyone. Today, I am Arindam Banerjee of BSc Second Year MPCS. I'm going to give a seminar, short seminar on the topic fire. Knows what is the major things required to cause fire?
That's fire.
Yes, ma'am.
F-I-R-E. Yes, somebody answer. What are the things essential to make fire?
Yes, ma'am.
Matchbox.
Fire only, ma'am.
You need matchbox. You need
matchbox.
Coal.
Two stones.
I think words also can lead to fire. Poisonous
just
words.
Having a matchbox will not catch fire. Just having a matchbox with us will not catch fire.
Yeah. You need wood or you need
fire itself. Is it a fire from humans or is a fire
which required to cause fire?
Is it fire means original fire or fire means what we fire on people? That fire. I got it.
Which fire?
It's a biological term, fire.
Okay, biological term. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, you can answer it for us.
Yes, ma'am. To cause fire, there are three things, major things required. One is the fuel, and the second one is oxygen, and the third and the main one is specific heat with which the fire will cause. Suppose a petroleum is kept in a water bottle. We fill the petroleum, 1 liter of petroleum in a bottle, and we kept a heated substance beside that. And oxygen is specific. Does it will cause fire?
You're not clear, ma. There's some audio problem, Arindam.
Yes, ma'am. I'll repeat. Yeah. Suppose 1 liter of petroleum is filled in a water bottle and kept, and beside that, any hot substance is kept, like immersion rod, like that, and the oxygen is present in air. So these are the three things required to cause fire. But in the condition I gave, does it will cause fire or not? That's the question.
Yes, it causes.
No, actually, it will not cause fire because the fuel is not getting contact with the specific heat and the oxygen. That's why it will not cause fire. If you open the cap of the bottle, then it will cause the fire. So I want to conclude here that there are four types of fire, actually total six types, but out of that four are the valid one and the two are combined in between in these four major types. The first one is A type, that is the solid one, the fire which causes in the solids. And the second one is B type, that is B type means barrel, causes fire, that is called as B type fire, like petroleum, diesel, kerosene, like that. And the C type is gaseous fire, like LPG, CNG, and like this will get fire. That is called C-type fire. And the D-type fire is metal fire, like copper, iron, which causes fire. That is called D-type fires. So, and the E-type is electricity. And the F-type is edible oils. So, Hello.
Carry on.
So the why I said that E and F types are not validated because in E type, I said that E type is an electricity type fire. In electricity, the fire mostly caused in wires. So in wires, we are having plastic that is called as a solid, and the metal is a copper. So the A type and D type are combining E type. So that's why F type is edible oil, which doesn't cause fire. At very rare cases, it causes fire. It works as a fuel to cause fire. Like if you put edible oil in some clothes or something, it will catch fire. But if directly you pour the oil somewhere and keep matching contact, it will not catch fire. So now for stopping different types of fire, there are different types of fire extinguishers. Can anyone guess how many types of fire extinguishers are there?
I know of only one fire extinguisher, that's water, sand, that's kept.
And that foam kind of thing, no? There is a foam kind of thing, no?
Seawater.
The one which we always place in the hospitals and offices.
Seawater, carbon dioxide.
Carbon dioxide, yeah.
Carbon dioxide.
Whenever you will see a fire extinguisher, you will see they will mention or what kind of fire type it has to be used. It will be mentioned from alphabet A to D, and where it should not be used, that also it will be indicated. Like for the A type fire, which is caused in solid things like plastic, wood, these kind of things, in that we can use A type fire, but we don't prefer A type fire because in solid things, if you keep water, it automatically stops causing fire. So that's why they don't use A-type fire extinguisher. Instead of that, normally people use water as a natural resource. So for petroleum and barrel-like substance, we use ABC dry powder is there and CO2 is there. Whenever a fire will cause in barrel and petroleum-like things, there the major thing is petroleum, which has to be stopped. But in many cases, like if the fire causes in petrol pump, we can't stop the fire by removing the petroleum from there. The only thing we can remove is the level of oxygen that we can reduce, and the fire will slowly discontinue. So for that, carbon dioxide spray is there, that is B type extinguisher. So when we spray carbon dioxide, the oxygen level decreases and the fire gradually stops. Even we can use ABC dry powder, which is C type C type fire extinguisher. We can use that also. And for C type fires, which is gaseous fire, that is in gaseous, suppose an LPG catches fire, we can't stop it by putting water or by putting something else. The fire will more and more increase. The only thing which we can remove from stopping the fire is oxygen. Or that ABC dry powder is there, which will block the main open edge of the LPG, and the fire will stop. Instead, the best thing which we are having at our home to stop LPG fire is blankets, not the blanket which we use in winter season, the blanket which we apply, keep on the feet warm. That blanket, if you cover on the LPG, that completely removes the percentage of oxygen from the area, and it will completely provide carbon dioxide to the LPG, and the fire will stop. And the D-type fire is metal fire, which for which the ABC dry powder is also used, and CO2 is also can be used. But CO2 we don't use because in that we will get reaction and something another can happen which can harm us more. So ABC dry powder is used basically for metals. So this was only my concept to give a basic knowledge of fire. If some fire incident happens in our locality, so that we can guide others and we can work out from there and we can save some others' life. If anyone is having any kind of questions or doubts, they can clear from me.
What we understood from this is before extinguishing any fire, a lot of thinking must go into it. We cannot run with water or anything. So different kinds of fires require different kinds of
estimation. I want to say.
Yes.
That I want to say that whenever a fire is caused, the major thing that we have to find out is what is the cause of fire. Suppose it is causing because of in a jungle. Suppose a fire causes in jungle. If you put water, it will work out. If the fire is caused in trees or something like that, but if the fire is caused due to fossils, the water will not work out. So that's the main thing we have to find out, that what is the cause of fire and according to which.
Yeah, Arindam, we got the point. That is, we need to know the cause of fire, because whether it's a cause due to electricity or whether it is a gas leak, or I mean, everything doesn't work in every situation, which is very valid information, because the first thing one does when you see a fire is throw water on it. Okay, so it doesn't work all the time. Very good. Yes, very
interesting.
Any other questions, ma, for Arindam? Any questions for Arindam? Students?
Everyone is silent.
Let's move on. Good, ma'am. Good, ma'am. Very informative presentation. Very nice.
Yeah, I too was. Actually, when I was initially listening to Arindam's topic, I was thinking, what is this? Arindam is giving us just information. Every time it is something that I take off. But at the end, you know, it was very not only informative, we have taken up so many things like, yeah, we don't need to just blindly put water or do something, but think about. Good, good. Yes, I think you're all the time raising your bar, Arindam. Very nice.
Thank you, ma'am.
Well done, Arindam.
One more thing I'll share with you, that about, I thought that that question will be asked after my speech, but no one asked that about sanitizers. We are getting a lot of news because of sanitizer we are causing fire. Uh-huh. What is that? The thing is that
alcohol based, no?
Why is the fire? Yes, ma'am, that is alcohol based. So the which type of fire can you say that? Which type of fire is that? In which sanitizer is causing?
Petroleum fire.
Petroleum. Sorry? And alcohol. Type C?
Yes, ma'am. Type C, gaseous type. Because the alcohol is evaporating and the fire is causing for the evaporation of the alcohol.
Good.
So in that, we are not able to see the fire in the sanitizer. Because in sanitizer, except alcohol,